got pushed to come in.
Paycheck yet?
Oh, yeah, man. It's a couple of weeks.
Hey, we got the mail coming in.
Let me go check. I got a envelope and AG coming in.
Physically recover.
Yeah. I'm good. How are you?
That little bit of time I spent out there. That.
It's. I just called. Just got off the phone. I went back to sure. This call came in. I was on the phone.
I don't ever want to do physically.
Well, it's not hard.
Okay.
That's that.
Okay.
The guys that I sent out there, the one time they came.
Just prior to.
You remember that?
5 minutes ago.
Yeah. Older gentlemen.
Yeah.
They're perfectionists.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't get something started out of the ground, right, or mm-hmm. if you do start it right, and then something happens and it rains and through and all that, then it's hard to get back right.
Right.
That was your fight.
Well, we did. I mean, it's such a cool playground.
It is.
It's so awesome.
It is.
And we fought for it. And
you did.
And so.
That's what I tell everybody.
It's done.
The people who went out there, like those mm-hmm. guys I sent, and just quit on y'all.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that they don't get the reward, you know.
There was what, so, it was what? So, it was so good. And we had what? So, I mean, it was so positive. And we still have, I mean, like love that while I was going out there and doing our landscaping this week.
Yeah.
Or next week, actually.
I enjoyed the time I spent out there.
Yeah.
It was fun.
It was fun. And yeah. Like, it's fun to look back on.
Yeah. That's over.
Uh-huh.
Still need me?
Yeah.
Hey, Jules, you come back here?
Yeah, I came for just a
minute. It's president of IBEW right here.
Are you wearing lipstick?
No, man, it's just how my lips look. They're just sexy like that.
This dude's wearing lipstick. Hey, when you got it, you got it.
It's my wire. Yeah.
Please don't encourage your pet animals.
They can't. Don't feed the animals. I love it. I didn't come up here for me. I just seen you drive by. I was at Sherwin Williams, and I drove by and I saw you and I said, "Well, I'm gonna speak to him." He won't answer the phone when I call, so I'm gonna come by.
We when we get royalty coming here. Oh my God,
has been, not anymore.
You still president?
I never was.
Businessman.
What are you? Businessman.
Businessman. That's it.
Adam's the president.
You want some lid?
I'm good.
Yeah, damn. Electrical boy.
You know, of me.
Just so you know, if you hear somebody talking shit about me, you can piss. You always get along. I got me pissed off. Who's the kid? Jim's pissed. My home. Planet playground shit. It was raining for 5 or 7 days we were building. We were all out there in the rain. And Jim didn't want to get rain. And so I didn't, that didn't go over good.
Seeing on TV true.
About what?
The Wendelin kid.
No, that's true. not a single word of true.
How's he able to put it on?
Because he doesn't have a job. All he has is social media. And because I look at Sue and Steve and gonna help with it. But because I'm an appointed official, I'm a quasi public official that I don't have slander protection, defamation protection. Man. He could literally say that, you know, he caught me in a hotel with a dead girl and a live boy, and ain't shit I could do about it. But if I had done anything that he said, I'd be in prison right now. He said I took $2 million and said I was whooping up on people all over the place.
Yeah, like a gangster.
Yeah, we got four employees that we got brought up. They're all Wesley's. He got caught embezzling some money about 3 years ago. I'm the one to turn him into AG. But they said they didn't have evidence to move forward because he couldn't locate the bank account information.
Who could? Who could?
The state auditor could. The reason is he kept giving them the wrong number. And it wasn't under this the name of the entity. The employee account.
You know, Miss Julie can only keep you straight for so long, and keep you out of so much shit.
It requires visual evidence.
This is what it runs into. You get Frank start hearing that bullshit, they start believing. Stacy came here and said, "I've been fucking up."
Damn right.
He wanted to know
what
this.
What'd you do?
He wants to know this shit. Weston is putting out the truth.
About what? What'd you do? Which one? About the money or corruption?
$2 million.
Just Tony, I'll tell you. I assumed there was some truth to some of this stuff. And I'm friends with Tony,
uh-huh.
And he asked me, we used to eat breakfast together.
Yeah.
And he asked me, he said, what do you think about Richie? And I told Tony the story about the first time I met him when he came to the office, sideways in that long black SUV and, you know, his 80 mile an hour trip in the parking lot. I said, that's pretty damn impressive. You know, the way he landed that truck, feeding the animal. And, but whether or not Richie's what we need, where he's at, I don't know, Tony. What I told him.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I'm going to go talk to him.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I'm here. That's why I came out here. I'm not going to talk about you.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just not that way.
Mm-hmm. So what do you, so
I just want to know that things are good.
Oh yeah, things are good.
I don't live in the city.
Moving forward on a lot of stuff.
You know.
Mm-hmm. Moving forward on a lot of stuff. We got stuck on some stuff we wanted IBW with, and that was on Tampa's project. Seemed like he would be bringing in some outside folks.
Oh, Jonathan.
Yeah,
okay.
Y'all haven't really got the calls we were expecting on that. But,
you know, that job's, from what I've heard, but I don't know any of it to be true, is the pay method is not
much. You're not going to pay during the pay?
No.
I think it's the timeline. It's not understanding. Is that what you're saying? The timeline of pay?
No. I don't. I was told that they just pay different. You know, and without me knowing facts, I really rather not say what I heard. You know.
Cash.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, I know. That's fair.
I don't like spreading rumors, but
we'd all be a lot better off if people operated in fact.
Well, I do. That's why I'm here.
You're paying cash?
I'm not gonna say that. You know, I'm just not, I just.
I'll tell you that, we stay away from that building because John Tampa is from.
Sorry, I'm not jumping this because you know I got popular things to do today. I'm not even supposed to be at work right now.
See.
Bye. It's good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you.
Call me if you need anything. I've got some emails in there.
John Tampa is.
Is that your wife?
Huh?
Is that your wife?
It's Tom Norman's wife. That's part of what we did, try to get everything people quit shooting in.
I knew that.
He's chair of the Republican Party. We're trying to create a team here, Rob, you know. We got people working for the Roderick. He's a hell of a project man.
Yeah, I'm sure she mad. I helped her out there at the playground.
Yeah, yeah.
And got guys to come in and help. I did know that she was something to do with Norman. I knew that.
No, we got progress going, and if we could just get them to work with us. And yesterday was the first time all of them worked with us in about a year and a half. That was on the road closure before we switched them by the road for our industrial park. But you're hearing I'm not the guy you need anymore.
That's why I'm here. I hope you can respect that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm looking you in the eye, and I'm not going to talk about you behind your back.
Yeah, one of them's going to be Jim Miles, and the rest of them will always up there pissed off at.
No, Jim Miles ain't said nothing. They ain't mentioned your name. Has not mentioned
it. Yeah. Well,
I'm going by what I see on TV.
Yeah, well, you're going by what you see on TV from what?
All of it.
Yeah.
That's all I know.
I made a commitment to the business community. I would not go back and forth with this guy. So his story and my story does not take precedent over what we're trying to do here. That is the key. I mean, we've got 22nd Avenue coming on. There's a building coming on up there. We got a couple new businesses coming on 39. Sidewalks going on Highway 80. We've got big shit happening. And I'm not going to sit here and fight with a 19-year-old that's never had a job, that doesn't understand ethics for one thing, but also take advice from his legal counsel. Instead, he goes off on his own, Bill Road. I'm not going to be getting off in that shit. Now, he throw me on the bus all he wants to, but I'm going to keep plugging along doing what I got to do.
Well,
but I'm also going to keep fighting.
They keep putting it on TV, and that don't help.
Yeah, it don't. Kind of like
I'm not on Facebook. I'm not on any social media.
What's
I don't
push that here?
I don't get. I was.
Yeah.
And when Cindy Hyde Smith, Mike Espy race happened,
mm-hmm.
and I had friends attacking me because I felt like Mike Espy was a better candidate,
mm-hmm.
I'm not going to let politics come between me and 20, 30-year friends.
Yeah.
I'm just not.
Yeah.
If a person is willing to vote DNR with no research, they're a fucking idiot.
I agree.
Either side.
At the same time, like in my situation, she got Willie Simmons running for.
Because the platform is just window dressing. If Republicans truly cared about babies, they wouldn't still be killing them in Jackson.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If Democrats were going to take my guns, I wouldn't have any by now.
You're right.
Or my God, I wouldn't be able to go to church.
Mm-hmm.
It's bullshit.
It is.
And I don't buy into it.
Yeah.
And that's why I got off social media. And when I see something on TV, I turn it off.
So what did you say about your mom on TV?
All of it. Anything to do, anything, anytime I hear a city councilman on TV go against the mayor.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if they disagree, fine. Leave it in the damn room.
I agree. Let's see. We tried everything. Team building was too powerful with him. We've had individual meetings with him and other members of the council. We've got the business community to talk to him. And what we continue to run into is what is said in our private meetings is not what is said when he goes outside. If he said camera on him, he wants to be famous. And you can't be famous unless you got somebody to fight against. And truth is, you're going to probably hear a lot of folks going to continue to say they don't like him. And I appreciate you telling me that, but at the same time,
I'm not asking you to change anything.
But I'm going to tell you, I'm not going to quit fighting that motherfucker because what he's trying to do is wrong. And he is continuing to slander my reputation.
I don't know what he's trying to do.
And that's fine. The one day I'm not gonna be doing this, and he's not gonna be doing that, and me and him are gonna settle up the way I used to settle up when I was in construction. I'm gonna beat everyone the fuck out of him, and then we'll try to see what happens then. But now, as far as me taking any money, no. He tried to accuse me of a hostile work environment. He had one disgruntled employee, 535 comes up here, who's one out of 10 embezzled the money, which we'll have to deal with him again. Yeah, they continue on. Whitney Diner didn't get to do me any favors either. He's finally gone.
Who?
Whitney Diner, Marine Star. No. But
I don't know all this stuff.
Yeah.
I stay out of it.
Yeah.
Really, I do. The only concern I have is my membership and keeping them working.
Mm-hmm.
And when I hear things like this, it affects the construction industry.
Mm-hmm.
It affects what I'm trying to do,
mm-hmm.
which is grow my membership.
Yeah.
Honest days pay for honest days work.
Mm-hmm.
And these type things affect businesses coming here. And
are you going to sit down with
Weston? I'm concerned. Huh?
You need to sit down with Weston.
Have I?
You need to. So here's his side of it, and he'll tell you everything I see what I've said.
Well, so, I hear what I see on ABC News.
About me?
Whatever you and Weston argue about. I hadn't been to a city council meeting.
Yeah.
I hadn't been to
the last time me and him had a real light-up conversation was back when he accused me of creating a hostile work environment. But now him and Bunky, and we got that lawsuit coming up.
When that Bunky Western thing got on YouTube,
mm-hmm.
that's when I started paying attention.
Yep, and you should have, because what you hear in that is a staged conversation. I don't have a way to read anybody's text messages. I don't have a damn trigger fish. First of all, you know what a trigger fish is?
Uh-huh.
It's got a little antenna. You can sit up on top of this building, and when it fools the towers. So the call you make goes, hits that trigger fish, and then it goes, let's say you call your wife, and then it goes to your wife. Kids, and you can listen in on the conversation. That piece of hardware costs about $250,000. I don't have $250,000, and I sure as hell don't give that much care to listen to what you and your wife are talking about. You go through there, and that whole freedom to speak bullshit, they think I'm in the damn CIA with all this shit they say I can do. What you have is a staged conversation between Weston and Bunky. Bunky is trying to state that he was terminated for creating a hostile work environment. That's not true. He was terminated because he was working with Kim Houston and Weston Lindeman to undermine Percy, because he made a deal with Kim that if she got elected, he would be her CAO. That's true. We found all that in text messages and emails. All that's going to be coming out in this court case. Weston's also going to be cross-examined and deposed during this shit. But then we'll see what he's going to say under oath. But they've taken a really good shot at it. I'll give them that. But they've run out completely out of ammunition. And I'm still standing.
I don't know who they is. All I know is Weston. He's the only one that I see attacking me. But
if I had somebody come down there in an IBEW and they never hooked up any wire, never pulled any wire, and they come down there and they start telling you how to hook up an electrical box, how'd you take that?
I'd sit back and see if they knew what they were doing. If they didn't, I would tell them that they don't know what they're doing. Thank you for your time.
And what if they continue to tell you, you don't know what you're doing? I Googled this. I know what I'm doing here. I know how to hook this damn box up. And you say, no.
I think it's time we part ways. Nice to meet you.
You can't
part ways. And I would walk off.
I say it's the boss's son. He continues to sit there and tell you.
We would part ways.
I'm going to tell you, I'm not parting ways. And that son of a bitch right there, he never had a job. He's had one part-time job in which he did the spotlights for Roger over here at the Temple Theater, and got him a job with Brad Chisholm during the Max deal. In which case, you want to know the other side, call Brad Chisholm.
I don't know him.
Or Lachlan.
I don't know him.
Or Pam.
Pam.
Johnson.
I know her.
Call any of our rabbis we got. Jerry Nash, Pam Johnson, Brad Chisholm. Any of them. Ask people that we trust, see what they say. Because we've been with them the whole way, asking them how the hell do we deal with this.
Pam is like that with Hood, you know, and
this is what I'm dealing with.
I really thought I was, but I'm not sure anymore if I am or not.
This is what I'm dealing with right here. Weston hangs out with Mr. Martin, who's crazy. Hangs out with Kevin Locke. Hangs out with a guy named Charles Kimbrough, who two times in the past 8 months has had to get me arrested. One time he threw himself against that wall in that hallway while I was in the front up there by the secretary, which no charges were filed against me. They had him found guilty of disturbance of a business.
Of what?
Disturbance of a business.
Okay.
He went full on Fight Club out there in the hallway, screaming, "Get off me, Richie, get off me, quit hitting me, quit hitting me," and recording me. So this is what we deal with now. This is one batch coming through. This is the Ethics Commission. Complaint. This is just the second and third batch we've got. I've got 9 more complaints just like this, and every one of them I've got to go to a hearing in Jacksonville. This is Weston's plan right here, to grind us down, deal with pulling information, and with the shit he puts out on Facebook on my emails. If you put out the first 5 or 6 emails behind it, and then the last 5 or 6 emails after the email he puts out, it'll make a lot of sense. But now, if I just go in your phone and I pull out one text where you said "fuck you," and I didn't pull out the other one where the guy said, "Hey, fuck you, buddy." And the last one, son, y'all start laughing when I get the beer, and I just pull up that one text where you said "fuck you." You think you hate that guy?
Oh yeah. Same thing you said. That's why I don't watch TV or do any of this.
That's one bit.
Because I see, like right there, I don't even look. Ticker tape parade celebrates U.S. women's soccer team. Okay, is that all that's going on?
No.
I don't know.
I'll tell you this. To give you an idea of how stuff gets framed and it's different, I've had a request our entire case file from the Attorney General's office on this Andreacchios deal because everybody's been said that we fucked the poops, were corrupt, and all this shit. And NBN.
Christian Andreacchios. Gotcha. Yeah.
And they say NBN, they didn't do a good investigation.
Mississippi Department of
Europe, yeah, NBI, Europe Investigation.
Yes, okay.
Then it was turned to the AG. The AG did an investigation, 3 separate investigations, all come to the same conclusion. What they're leaving out is the fact that he threatened to kill himself 10 times 2 days before he shows up there. Anytime I put that pistol in his mouth, they neglect to show all this stuff before and after. It doesn't meet the narrative. They want to sell podcasts. They want to damn people to get listeners. And so now we've got to find a way to get the entire truth out there. But I don't want to do it, and now I got to piss on some dead kid's memory. At the same time, I can't have the faith of the community and our law enforcement department over here shook. Everybody right now is spreading corruption. If we did anything that Weston said or anything these other people were saying about corruption, we would be in prison. Mm-hmm. Yes. And I would tell
maybe
you,
one day.
I would tell you.
But it don't happen quick.
No, it don't. And
something like that could take 10 years.
And I tell you this, you tell your people, anybody that.
Ain't no people. I called it on TV.
Let me
tell you this much.
There is no statute of limitations on the government, on anything dealing with mismanaging money, anything dealing with corruption. There is no statute of limitations. You fuck up here, you do something illegal, it may take 20 years and you're done.
Same with IBW.
And I'm going to tell you, I sleep good at night. They ain't done shit. Percy had done shit. But what we have done is turn a shit ton of people in who were doing bad things. One of which was defended by Weston, being Magruder. Caught him in Bethlehem. Caught him having his son live in Hattiesburg, which he said was working here in Meridian. Found that shit, turned it in, and what happens?
I ain't heard all this.
But when you do the right thing, you piss off another group of people. You piss off another group of people.
I mean, you can't keep
right now, we have a bunch of people pissed off at it, but we've done the right thing.
I'm not pissed off. I'm curious.
Yeah. Hey, anything you want to see, I show up to.
I don't want to see it. I just want you to tell me that
we're not going to
things are okay.
Yeah, things are okay.
I ain't worried about that.
Things,
I'm worried about the city and my membership. What happens right here affects my membership. That's all I care about.
That we were experiencing more growth by now than we have ever experienced. Tell them right now that we're less than a month away from announcing 300 jobs with Project Stream.
Amazon.
B.S. Smith or some shit, some stupid name like that. It's a
really industrial bad park.
No, not industrial park.
On that way?
No, this is going out here, Loblolly or whatever else. This is a corrugated box.
You shook a little bit when I said Amazon.
Yeah, no, it ain't Amazon. Everybody keeps saying Amazon. And I was trying to think maybe you knew somebody. Maybe these people were doing boxes for Amazon to ship. But no, it's like D.S. Smith or B.S. Smith or some shit. It's called Product Strength.
Are you talking about on Not Combs Road?
I think it's out there.
Hold on. I know where it's at.
It's up to Mount Meridian. 6:30 to be with the family all weekend. Kind of being offshore, we better not.
You met with David, you met late? He's paying the fine.
Last time I saw him hanging up was, she had a guest couple, 3 or 4 weeks ago. She went ahead and if she wanted to see her.
You going to the letter management in Biloxi next week? What you know what is all that? 1.2 million
square feet.
It's bigger than Hannah Hartman again. That explains why they wouldn't, whoever this is wouldn't use Hannah Hartman. I've been upset this month because we had a building that we were using all of it while we were doing this, you know.
Yeah, but right now, they don't need to be supposed to be drawn. Just we found that put a box in right here, or substation.
Yeah.
But this shit's going to go all down through this way.
I don't see air and weight. Chamber of Commerce. They call it BNBC. They won't let me join.
Reason is that everybody they're trying to recruit down here that almost said they have a union involved.
Yeah. Why? What's wrong with me? What's wrong with us?
They don't need to have those.
Ain't nothing gonna happen.
I'd say we need to have. Because they say, all right, as long as y'all want to join BNBC, that's fine. But just know anybody you get down here, they're gonna be a shit ton of IBEW boys show up at your damn job site out here with the ticket sign. So, you ain't gonna
do that.
You don't wanna do that?
I ain't gonna be the bad guy. Then the views will get a hold of that and I'll be even worse than we already are. I know how this town works, Mississippi. A D by your name don't mean nothing. You're either gonna get an R.
But they trust balls.
You're gonna get an
R. You know who gets along with anybody here? Because he's got balls. Fucking Steve Wilson.
Who?
Steve Wilson. That's some bitch who doesn't respect about the public and Democrats a lot. Because he's got nuts. In the end, he's fighting the same thing. I mean, that shit we all
he's
are.
He's hard
exactly. I was there and I didn't get inducted. And Steve, man, that's what
that's what he said you did.
No.
That's what he said. You know what he did? See this shit where Weston Lynn, Gus or Weston Lynn, he charged the shit to the room. And when we know that he did this shit, on
fraudulent statements.
Huh? Yeah, fraudulent statements. There you go. That's what we gave him.
He said. That's what he said you did. Yeah, on TV.
Yeah, he's trying to bait and switch.
What?
Yeah. But where is it? Damn,
Google.
When did he say it recently?
And wasn't that what, am I wrong? Is that not what was on TV?
When?
Shit, I don't know how, when was that done? What's the date on the, what's the date on the chart?
I didn't
take a while here. I just wanted
to. I know, you want to say this shit. But I had never spent a public dollar in my life. What I do have is some of us that doesn't like me, because I think we're close to the same age.
You know, there was a team when he went in office.
It was the city from day one. Happened. Now from day one, what it was, is Weston was a Bernie Sanders delegate. And at the national level, 19 years old, and he supported Bernie Sanders. He will get some recognition, all right? In Mississippi, supported Bernie Sanders, showed the ball. Comes back home now. You get on the city council because you're riding the mayor's coattails. That Bernie Sanders shit ain't gonna fly in the city of Meridian. So what he did find is he did throw rocks at the first black mayor as a 19-year-old kid. You gonna get some friends. But it's the same son of bitches that I was fighting in 2013, toting rebel flags and hanging nooses and shit. One dude called me on a campaign phone, called me a, you know, fucking vanilla face and snowflake, and tell her to watch my back. And them fuckers can say if they want to, that shit don't scare me now.
Me neither. Hey, I got videos of some real nice vehicles driving by my house. And some of them, you know.
Mm-hmm. I believe it.
Yes. Yesterday.
There you go.
It's happening right
you
now.
You guys might follow me?
Yes, sir.
Baby.
I didn't even talk about it. I hope they do make them money.
Just the driving their shit, bro.
I don't give a fuck what they're trying to do. You want to see us so nuts, I got them.
Tell me that. I'll tell you everything about them right now. Right, the software on here.
I don't need it.
Well, you need to know what all those cars they got.
I don't need it.
Okay.
Trust me.
My injury.
This morning, boy. This shit's happening at midnight and 1 o'clock in the morning. Some of it happens in the daylight. But it's a bunch of them.
I think
it's tied to that number.
You live
tied to that Michael Gray sign in the yard, I think.
You live in the county? Michael Gray's on the DJ?
Yeah. That's what I was told.
I just say, yeah, same with Cassie. I'm doing this other. I'm with Cassie. I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Okay. If the man's asking for something and nothing wrong, give it to him. Yeah.
They're not showing everything. So this shit right here, this is paid for by them, paid for by the family. And I'm gonna show you this guy, trust you, gonna do it here. Our guys did a shitty job taking pictures. They called it down to suicide early. At the same time, they did have his cell phone, they did have a ballistic. And what I want you to see, one of them two, either that girl or that guy, put his ass off his toilet, laid him in there. The reason they did is they didn't get it in his wallet. To me, that looks kind of easy where he had a skull can in his wallet right here. They needed that to try to clean out his money, all right? After some blood. Yeah, after some blood, though, this is it. Now, we've shown two different suicide videos, all right? You take that camera, you put it right up to your head. He pushed it so hard that down
slide, pin on the slide, it his head bruised it bad. But that bullet he was using was a hard, you can see it, but it's gonna look like a black talon hollow point. The thing is, it's right up against his head. That somebody goes through and through. There's some blood splatter, but it's real minimal. When you shoot yourself in the head, it's lights out. One thing that always stays is that trigger finger always gonna be pulled because body just short circuits, everything stops. But at the same time, it's not like the movies where it blows the whole side of your skull. It's not like a shotgun going through. All the blood, when you shoot yourself in the head like he did, it all comes out your eyes, your nose, your mouth. And it'll come down like this. Now, he probably sat there shooting himself, I would say about 45 minutes to an hour. And I'll show you
why. After he shot himself.
After he shot himself. I see if the shot coagulated his blood. If he did shot himself, this shit would not be getting jelly like. It wouldn't be getting coagulated.
What was that? How long was there? Did he have long hair?
Yeah, he had long hair. The one he was going to shoot himself in the head, long hair. Hair goes kind of everywhere. I dated a girl. It's actually Bud, not Bud, Butch Lee's dog. She killed herself about 6 months ago. She was beautiful. She had really long hair. He shot himself with a Kimber 45, with a damn good bullet going through there real fast. She shot herself with a damn 38 Special snub nose shooting shorts, hollow points. When she put that sumbitch upside her head, it blew the whole top of her skull out. Same time though, it went through the hardest point on her head. The hardest point of your head is on top. He shot himself in the weakest point of his skull. He'd put it here and it'd come out of here, it'd blow the whole top of his damn head off. You put it here, soft in your temple, soft in this temple, bullet goes in about inch above his ear, it comes out about 3-4 centimeters above his ear. So if you put it here, run a line through his head, it's exactly where he was sitting on the toilet. There's no way to get there. And the way it's held is like this. Now, if I'm gonna shoot you, perfect, I would have to be in the damn tub. Put the fucking gun to the side of your head all gangster-like and shit. That's in the fucking movie, man. But there ain't no way somebody gets a drop on him. This is where the bullet went. The mode's right here. Bullet comes through. See, minimal splatter. This ain't nothing on the side. See, they did this before. You want to get a check?
No.
Bullet is right here. Stud. As an electrician, you know a stud's going to be right there.
On one side or the other?
Yeah. Bullet hits here, and when it hits that stud, it hits something that comes back. Like this. But it knocked a lot of velocity off. It landed in the tub. There's a little nick up there kind of by the ceiling, and it lands back in the tub. But it hit that stub, and then there's like a, your nails. Your damn hanging wire and shit.
Yeah, Romex nails.
There's your bullet. All right? There ain't no doubt them fuckers clean blood up.
Why'd they do that?
Man, trying to figure out the next move. They had to rob him. You're dealing with two drug dealing ass people. He shoots himself in the head. Most people call 911. These some of us didn't. They sitting there going, he's dead now. Let's get him money. That's the other part. If you're dead and I take your wallet, you can't charge me a robbery. That's the damnest shit. If you're dead,
damn, I can't hit it.
Charge me with theft. I took your shit. Mickey Mouse, Mr. Mayor.
What?
Listen, this is what they keep telling us. This is what they wipe their blood up with. They try to make it seem like he killed himself in that tub.
Who?
Swearing to it.
Why?
Because they didn't get his wallet out of his pocket.
So they were like that?
Yeah. Okay, you didn't deal with them.
They didn't think it, right?
No, you ain't. Yeah. I just gotta show you something. It's nasty. You can see it, alright? Alright. This
mode, she was like, yeah, something's gonna hit right there. And that's exactly what it did. This shit right here, this is libidity. When you die, gravity takes your blood and it goes to the lowest point, all right? Now, if he'd been laying over that tub when he killed himself, all the libidity would have been here, on the front, and on his chin.
That's that's their complaint.
Let's see how, when you see all the libidity's here, the reason that libidity is there is because he was sitting on the tub. He was sitting on the commode when he shot himself. He was probably sitting there a while they were getting their shit figured out. Alright? That's right here.
Shit figured out.
But
listen. I know that. There's two sides, three sides.
Mm-hmm.
Mine, yours, and what really happened.
Mm-hmm.
I know that. To every story.
Mm-hmm.
Not that anybody's lying on either side. I don't know. But listen to me. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Did the boy?
Tell us that?
No. Did the boy? What is it? Did him?
Mm-hmm.
Did he coerce the boy into getting off the boat and going home?
Yeah. What you end up seeing is this right here. This is his text. Why he's on the boat.
I don't know what it says. I can't see that.
If this doesn't work when I get to my apartment, he's on the boat. He writes it. If this doesn't work when I get to my apartment, I'm putting my pistol in my mouth and I'm ending this. I'm ending this once and for all. Because Whitley is the closest I've ever been to happiness. Without that, it doesn't get any better from there. I don't want to get worse. And that is it for me. We have always been living to die. So why love? Why keep dragging out lives? Why keep dragging our lives out? Let's just kill ourselves and get it over with. Whitley, if that's the case, let's just both kill ourselves. This is from the AG. Now they've got it all coming from you, but the deal is, that old girl did her a FOIA request too. Since the case is closed, she's got all the texts. Now what's about to happen is that podcast is gonna be going, oh shit, here we are, damn, saying that somebody's been murdered and facing it, and the parents are saying, you know, we'll kill himself, and here all that shit is there, we're talking about killing himself. It's 12
bit. From what I know, it sounds to me like they won't. If he did kill himself, then prove it to me.
But this is what fucked it up. We told the family of everything. He killed himself. We can't charge him with murder. But what we can charge him with is tampering with evidence, with death, or something else. And in the end, or disturbing the body, desecrating the body, some shit like that. They only got 7 years apiece. They would have got 7 years, and they could have said third day to day. Then Drecky said, "It's nothing. It's not murder. We don't want it. This is a key right here. When you're dead, you bruise differently. Okay? See? You're crushing. You're sitting on a commode. No, I'm just saying, that's what that is. That's somebody gripping you down around your hips, trying to get you off that commode. They gripped him so hard and bruised him. You see this? Him laying on top of that tub. Gravity ain't going the opposite way. He's sitting on the damn commode for no telling how long. Location with this. You see a kind of bullet he shoots himself with? Has been a nice kimber too. See the hammer on D-top? What nobody wants to say, and nobody wants to admit, I got two pussy ass officers that won't admit to it either, is the first thing they do when they get to a scene like this, is they secure the gun. One of our officers decocked that pistol. They decocked the gun.
As it should have, I guess.
And murders at home? Shit, it's discretionary, but at the same time, ain't nobody going in the bathroom gonna pick the damn gun up and shoot something. Gun should have got left where it was. But the guy, in his discretion, he decocked it. Well, it changed the way the whole scene looked.
if the gun's decocked and it's a Kimber 45, now it looks like damn somebody shot him and decocked it. That shit doesn't happen. Our guy did that. He fucked up.
And then where is it between?
Put it back where it was. That's what he did.
Okay. So it was not wedged, right?
Yeah, it was wedged, but he put it right back where he... He won't admit to it, but that's where we...
That's what y'all think?
Mm-hmm. This is your little bit of splatter going on the, this is your bullet. It's not, the bullet is not your typical hollow point. Let's see if you see another one. Let's see if we go back up here. This hollow point. And some of this right here is not, it looks almost like it's got like a, it's hard looking, like it almost like a black diamond bullet, you know? That's what you need. That's the key here. This shit all in here, this is all brain matter, all right? But that's also damn
sheetrock.
Sheetrock. They saying damn.
I see that. Like that. Oh, it looks like it.
Yeah. And they saying damn, he got shot in the tub. How in the hell he gonna shoot himself in the tub and make all that shit line up? The other part is how fucked up this bullet looks right here. I can see that going through his head, hitting that wall. I can see how that bullet ends up ricocheting up in the air. I mean, there ain't no telling what it's gonna do. Bullet just looks like shit. But it's full of sheetrock. That's the big guy I say right here. Suicide can be excluded as a possible matter of death. You know what this guy says then? That he's paid by the Andreacchios. He's paid. This is what he's supposed to say.
See, that's the shit that I don't think anybody should say what they think they're supposed to.
Yeah, I agree.
That's why I'm here looking you in the eye today.
Mm-hmm.
Richie?
Yeah.
Tony, if I'm good, he's anxious.
Uh-huh.
And so until he told me that, Richie's a thug. He's fucking. He's.
No.
I don't know anything. Yeah. Yes or no.
Yeah.
But that's what I thought. And I'm looking in the eye.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, if I was a thug.
Listen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I've always looked up to Tony. He was teaching my Sunday school class.
Mm-hmm.
So when I heard that, I had to accept the fact that I had to look you in the eye.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you what I'm telling you.
Mm-hmm. I go and tell you, I'm not a thug, but I'll fight like hell.
Okay.
And I will beat the shit out of somebody. At the same time, my reputation will be everything to me.
Are you talking about like this fight?
You goddamn right. I mean,
yeah.
Other part of it is, anybody, I should resign a long time ago. I'm not getting chased out of town by some bitch that ain't never had a job in ruining this city. We had everything rocking and rolling. You about to have a damn brewery going in right here. This son of a bitch right here is going. The Max is going. Children them going. We got 22nd Avenue getting redone. We got finally got the damn industrial park. We got business going on 39. It's finally starting to kick. And what has happened is, if one kid gets in to make a name for himself, and the way he's trying to do it is pretty corrupt. I go say, I'm not corrupt. But any of your guys, if they want me to come over and talk to them, I'll be glad to. But now, if they start accusing me of being corrupt, I may not get out of there without getting a little bloody. But somebody will step to me and call me corrupt. I'm going to be beating the shit out of them in that office. I ain't taking nothing, and I ain't done a goddamn thing. That is what it is.
That's why I'm here.
That is what it is.
I hope you can respect that.
I can. By the time you tell them, anybody, you can tell anybody that wants to say I'm corrupt, you tell them this. Tell me, and I'll be done. I'll be down there just a little bit. I'll take this old fucking vest off and this tie, and I'll get back to where it was when I was in the construction.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll settle like we used to.
Yeah.
And just tell them I'll win.
Look, I don't know what you're trying to tell me or whatever. You're trying to send me a message.
No, I'm trying to tell you I ain't taking shit. I appreciate you coming to talk to me.
I hope
but
you do.
Same time.
Would you rather?
Ain't no boy up there going to be down trying to tell me I stole nothing either. tell them.
Who told you that?
No, I just, when you said thought I was a thug, I assumed somebody.
I did.
Somebody thought I was taking something.
I could've told you. Everything I know comes from the TV.
Yeah. But I tell you what.
About you and this guy.
And it has fucked me for life, too. He has.
What?
I'll never get another job dealing in politics simply because of the accusations this motherfucker's made.
Look, you and Percy told me that I was your friend.
You are.
But yet you continue to let the NBDC shut us out. And I'm pissed off about it.
And you think that we and
I don't want part of the NBDC anymore.
Yeah, but you.
Fuck them.
But you thought me and Percy can damn have that business community let you in when we can't damn. We cut all their funding. They don't get any. They didn't get any money this past year from us. In the end.
They don't need.
Yeah.
Not who they got sitting on. They don't need the money. They like to have it. They don't need the money.
Yeah.
They got plenty sitting on. What you and Percy told me.
Yeah.
That we were partners.
We are. Look, bro.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Tell everyone wrong.
Thank you.
Same here.
All right. And let me know if you ever really tell me you're driving past my house.
That's it. See you. Yeah.
I'll see you, Steve.
See you, man.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah. Come on. That's against fire code, by the way.
It is, that's why I didn't want to go say that, but thank you.